my monstrosities I've made.
Bloody piping on it, so complicated.
Okay, now these tanks are safe. They've got this water level on here. This one has got it on too. And now they're both of these are connected by pipes down there. They'll be secured later on. And they all run into this sump here. Now, probably in a week's time, I'm thinking about adding a coil valve to this to try and help kind of top up, rather than having to come back and fill this up consistently all the time. But that's going to be another pain, because I'm going to have to try and figure out, not knowing anything about plumbing, figure out how to hook a pressure hose, and what I'm going to use, to the tap over there, which will connect to this sump here to the ball valve. But it has to be strong enough to hold the constant pressure of the water coming from the tap. And the hoses, normal hoses, won't do this. And they'll hold for a little while, but then they'll just blow. So I'm going to have to speak to a plumber about that and see what I can do about that eventually. But I've just spoken to Bunnings and they said that I can get a ball valve for about $35. Another couple of dollars for the ball, so about $40 for a ball valve all up. And I'll just have to figure out what sort of pipe to use to connect it to the tap.